Good evening, and welcome back, Wildcats, to the 2020 athletic season, as we kick it off with the 63rd edition of the Wildcat Sports Network. I'm Addison Whitney. That's right, there's a new face for the Wildcat Sports Network, as I will be taking over for Nick Luttrell, and those are some pretty big shoes to fill. But hey, move on over, Nick, because there's a new sheriff in town, and this is my show. On tonight's show, we look back as the Wildcats took on the number one team in the state of Oklahoma, Jinx. We catch up with Coach Wood, see what our Lady Wildcat volleyball team has been up to, plus talk COVID-19 and how it's impacting sports as a whole. We have a ton of action coming up, so sit back, relax. The 2020 athletic season is upon us. It's Friday, September 4th, 2020, and the Wildcat Sports Network starts right now. Kicking the 2020 season off, as always, is Coach Wood. Coach, last week our Cats took a tough loss against Jinx, the number one team in Oklahoma. What are your takeaways?
Well, I mean, I thought first, our guys played really hard all the way through. They fought to the very end. It just came down to miscues offensively and defensively. I mean, we had six turnovers. And anytime you're playing an elite team like Jinx, you can't turn the ball over. And then defensively gave up a number of big plays, which we try to minimize that in each game. So kind of those two things added together. And, you know, we came up short by 16 points, but it wasn't because of heart and effort by our guys. So I was really proud of that. Just got to clean up the little things, mistakes in the game itself.
It looked like you guys had no problem moving the ball last week, but turnovers seemed to kill you. How are you working on ball security for tonight's game?
Well, I mean, the biggest thing we went back and looked at, we had three possessions in the red zone, and we turned the ball over in all three of those possessions. And so I think that could have been the difference in the game. It's just going back and just, you know, a lot of our stuff, our guys didn't do that intently. A lot of young guys were playing for the first time, and so they know. And so it's something we're not harping on. We're not, you know, it's just something we're going to get better at. And I think our guys understand the importance of protecting the ball, especially in the red zone, because you have scoring opportunities in there. And so this week, we just got back to the grind, showed them really good film, and they've had the right work ethic all week getting us ready for this game.
On the flip side, defense played really well, but gave up too many big plays.
Yes.
Is that a focal point of this week's practice?
Yeah, that was. I mean, you know, we've got to do our assignments each and every down. And I thought our run defense overall was pretty sound and solid. But we've got to come back on that. I think we had eight plays of over 20 yards. And those are consistent in the big plays. And a lot of our team goals hinges on that our offense creates big plays and our defense minimizes. And we only had three big plays of 20 yards or bigger on offense. Defensively, we gave up eight, and that kind of hurt us in that. So just, you know, those guys defensively went in. They're making those adjustments. The guys really focusing on assignments and understanding, you know, how that plays into winning and losing football games.
I noticed that compared to last year, we barely had any penalties called against us this past game. Has that been a focus point this year?
Yeah, I was real proud of our guys Friday night that, you know, the yellow flag wasn't thrown much. And part of that, when you go back and watch film, there were opportunities. I think the officials let us play. I mean, I really appreciated that, those Oklahoma officials. They just let the game flow both ways. And so there wasn't, I think that was that was part of the reason there were not a lot of flags thrown, is officials let us play, both teams. But I was real proud of our guys, our discipline. And it was nice to see that a lot of drives weren't stopped because of penalties. And defensively, drives didn't stay alive because of penalties. So that was good.
Let's change gears and talk about the elephant in the room, which is COVID-19. I mean, we saw last week how our players were 6 feet apart at all times. What are some changes that you've had to implement this year?
Well, there's more than some. I mean, it seems like every day we're always adding to, you know, our protocols and procedures. It started back in June with us, you know, and testing the four questions daily, taking temperatures of each player every day they come into our building to start the day, continuing to stress social distancing, maintain at least 6 feet spacing and distance. On the practice field, we move in and out of all our drills pretty quickly. We don't stay in anything for a prolonged time, so our guys aren't around each other that much on the practice field, and really using space to our advantage. And then on Friday nights, I mean, we've tried a little bit of everything, but we've kind of got those P dots on the ground. We measure those out before the game. We ask our guys to stay on that. We've also put cloth coverings on their helmets. I think we're one of the only teams in the state doing that right now, because even on the sideline, you got to keep a mask on if you're not actively involved. And so for us, we found these masks that, you know, is up against their nose, it covers their face, and they're wearing those on Friday nights, all even on our Monday teams. So we're doing that as well. Now, are we perfect in that? No, by any means, but our guys are striving to get better each and every time out and understanding, you know, what's at stake, and our season's at stake, not doing these little things. So those are just a few of the things we're trying to do to help allow us to play each and every Friday night.
So the stadiums are going to have 75% less people in them. How does this affect the team?
Well, I mean, you know, the biggest thing for our team is, one, our fans do a great job cheering and supporting them. And, you know, we, of course, every high school athlete would love a packed house every Friday night or on game night. But we understand under this year and the circumstances, you know, it's going to be 25% capacity. I know, you know, it's going to be full under those. And so our guys are going to play for the love of the game. We also know we have a great following on our social platforms. A lot of people be at home on YouTube watching the game. I think we're going to get really good followings there. So, you know, we know deep down that if our fans are in the bleachers or at home, we've got great support for what we're doing on a Friday night.
Coach, thanks for joining us. Coach Wood will be joining us back later to help close this thing. But first, if you missed last Friday night, don't worry. We've got the highlights coming at you right now.
HAR-BER Wildcats kick off the 2020 season literally against Jinx, the number one team in Oklahoma, at Jinx. Let's get to the highlights. Our opening drive, we've got Jinx number four taking it to the 40-yard line, but Tommy Hudson says, no sir. Drew McClendon takes a snap and will look deep for Peyton McKee, and he connects for a 45-yard pass. First down, HAR-BER. Jinx up 10-0, HAR-BER looking to come back. Drew McClendon looks deep again, connects with Ethan Fender for a 35-yard pass. First down, Wildcats. Second quarter action here, Drew McClendon says, jump on my back, boys, I got this. One defender, two defender, three defender, four, before finally running out of bounds. That's a first down, Wildcats. Same drive, McClendon hands it off to Hudson Brewer. This time, he's going to run it in, nearly untouched. 15-yard touchdown, HAR-BER strikes back. Looking for a comeback here, Drew McClendon is going to connect with Arrington McRae. He steps out and says, my bad, dog. Later on, fourth quarter action, Trojans looking to score, but look at Will Haney. Look, Ma, no hands. He catches this, interception, HAR-BER. We're going the other way. Later on, fourth quarter, looking to charge back, Lane Reeder with a 20-yard run. First down, HAR-BER. HAR-BER in the red zone now, McClendon looking to drive. He's going to take this one on himself. Touchdown, HAR-BER. We don't take those little one-pointers. He's going to hand it off to Lane Reeder. Runs that one in. HAR-BER looking to come back. They stand within striking distance, but Isaac Kramer with a fumble on that one. That's going to seal the deal as Jinx takes the victory formation. They walk away with this one, 31-15. Up next, HAR-BER takes on North Little Rock with their senior night and their first home game of the season. For WCSN, I'm Nick Luttrell.
The Wildcats endured a tough loss last week against the top-ranked Trojans, but are looking to bounce back tonight with their first home game of the 2020 season against North Little Rock. And bonus, tonight is senior night. Make sure you tune in as we honor the seniors. Right now, we're going to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, Noah Livingston is in the studio. Don't go anywhere. The Wildcats Sports Network will be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
If you want fast, easy, and affordable service, visit McLarty Daniel.
Keep your vehicle running like new in our state-of-the-art service facilities. We know your time is valuable. Our factory-certified technicians with decades of experience will get you in and out and back on the road quickly. We service all makes and models at our six convenient locations in Bentonville and Springdale, open 6 days a week.
Visit McLartyDaniel.com to schedule your service appointment today.
During the Great Depression, nothing came easy. But with just 5 cents, an old truck, and a load of hay, John Tyson and his family found a way to deliver quality chicken to other hardworking people. Today, Tyson continues to find new ways to help put a chicken in every pot. Because people deserve farm-raised chicken of the highest quality. At Tyson, we remain committed to this simple promise: to always keep it real, to always keep it Tyson.
you can love where you live and play at an apartment community managed by Lindsay Management Company. Affordable apartments with awesome amenities, including clubhouses, fitness center, pools, tennis and basketball courts, and playgrounds at select locations. Many locations also include golf privileges, business centers, game rooms, tanning beds, whirlpools, saunas, and resort-style swimming pools. View rates, photos, and apply online at lindsaymanagement.com.
Accidents are never planned. But no matter how small, every emergency that involves a child is a big deal. It's everything. That's why we're here. Arkansas Children's Northwest offers the only pediatric emergency room in Northwest Arkansas. With fast access, pediatric experts, and kid-sized care. Peace of mind when you need it most.
We came to Arvest Bank to see what makes it different.
It's a community bank that really reaches out to the customers to make them feel special. I feel special every time I come in here.
They want to be involved in the community. They want to be part of the community.
They support our university, our athletic department.
They've told us that they could have a fleet of volunteers there to help this year if we need it.
I see them at a lot of our Hispanic community events that we do.
I can't think of another bank in the city that has such a big community presence as Arvest.
Arvest Bank, our customers say it best.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, you gotta own it. You gotta be like, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Okay, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Better.
Okay, yeah, but don't you think I should add like some?
Red, yellow card.
Is she gonna be okay?
Yeah, they always do this.
Okay, so you said, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Yeah, just
no. But don't you think that I should add something like, that's the way the cookie crumbles, or, ooh, okay, good one. I could say something like,
no, just one more time.
Okay, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Much better.
Welcome back. COVID-19 has taken the world by storm and changed how we live. Over the summer, there was a possibility of not even having a sports season at all. But thanks in part by the state, the district, and our administration, our athletic department has come up with a plan that allows us to watch our cats and allow them to play. Our WCSN team was standing by to bring the story on just how this season may look a little different. Take a look.
The HAR-BER High School 2020 athletic season is underway, but this year it may look a little different.
I think Corona's made the whole school system be a little bit more flexible. You gotta set aside dedicated time to go through all of the ADH questions about every player coming in and asking them all the four questions, doing a check mark. That's made things very challenging, not just in athletics, but in the classroom and the whole school system, is all this contact tracing.
With the new protocols being enforced statewide, both the coaches and the players are focused to adapt to a new season.
I was kind of nervous going into tennis season because I thought like all the upperclassmen were gonna be like, kind of scary, but now that we're all together like playing all the time, it's a lot better. And if there wasn't Corona, I feel like we'd be more spaced out. We can't be together like super close, but we can like be together, like we can be 6 feet apart, but I feel like it's still team bonding, like it's still working because we're talking and having fun all together.
Whenever I'm playing doubles with my brother, I'm not able to give him any high fives or fist bumps. So what we do instead is we do racket taps. So you'll see us just kind of like give each other a little tap whenever we've played a point or won a point or anything like that. And also whenever we finish a match, we can't shake the hand. We have to just do the racket tap as well.
For these Wildcats, they've embraced the new changes and adapted to become more successful than ever. And with the guidance of head coach Larry Lawson, his outlook on the season has never changed.
I'm excited that we're still getting to have regular school for one thing, and I hope we continue because it will be nice to watch this group of seniors and the underclassmen get through a whole tennis season and have a chance to compete for a state championship again is the overall idea and belief behind a lot of these kids.
So make sure you do your part, mask up, and come and support our HAR-BER Wildcats. And though you may not be able to be there in person, you can catch every live stream on Wildcat Sports Network. For WCSN, I'm Sierra Scarlett.
Our stadiums will be operating at a 75% reduction this season. So if you can't make it to the game, don't worry. The Wildcat Sports Network will be bringing you all live event coverage every Tuesday and Thursday as volleyball season is underway. And of course, every Friday night for Wildcat football. Let's take another quick commercial break to hear from a few of our sponsors. But don't go anywhere. When we come back, Noah Livingston will be joining us. You're watching the Wildcat Sports Network.
Catering provided by Domino's.
Ballpark Franks got their start in 1957. Right here in the ballpark. And with the taste of 100% Angus beef, passed down from one generation to the next, they soon became a tradition everywhere, bringing on the feeling of summer in every bite. Ballpark Franks, bring on summer.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means you'll find less waiting where it matters most. Faster care in the emergency room. The 30 Minutes or Less ER Service Pledge at Northwest Health System, Bentonville, and Springdale.
Try the 3-and-3 meal at Slim Chickens. Three hand-breaded chicken tenders paired with three perfectly fried wings, shaken in your choice of house flavors. Served with fries, Texas toast, and a medium drink. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
Welcome home to Lindsay Living. From value-packed basic apartments with appliances and washers and dryers to resort-style apartment living on golf courses with fabulous amenities, you'll love where you live and play. Visit lindsaymanagement.com to apply online and see photos, rates, and floor plans for all locations we manage throughout Arkansas and in surrounding states.
Choose the Wellness Centers at Springdale Schools. The Wellness Centers in Springdale are perfect for students and teachers. Teachers can go during their planning period, and parents don't have to miss work for students to receive medical care. Offering sports physicals, kindergarten physicals, vaccinations, well child checks, acute care, and more. Wellness Centers are located at a school near you. Wellness Centers and Springdale Schools, we are your medical home.
Hey, Nick, catch.
Welcome back. Here with us in the studio is Noah Livingston. Noah, thanks for joining us. Now, we've seen how COVID has affected teams and athletics as a whole, but how has this crazy time affected you personally and your team?
So I feel like how it's affected me personally and my team is we can't really hang out like we used to, you know, hanging out in the indoor, hanging out in the locker room. I feel like connecting even outside of football is even harder than it is. Trying to like grow a bond with the new sophomores that had just come up is a little more difficult also.
Last Friday at 7 p.m., it felt like 105 degrees out. Even towards the end of the game, we saw a few players from Jinx go down, but our Wildcats seem to be in much better shape. What are your thoughts?
I feel like we take our conditioning very seriously, and all week we've been practicing out in the heat, so that way I feel like Coach Wood and the rest of the coaches had prepared us very well for the game, and we were just ready to go out there in the heat and do our thing.
Let's talk about tonight's game. Last year, we ended off our season against North Little Rock. Tonight, our second game and our first home game will be against them. What can we expect to be different against them this time?
What I expect to be different is that I feel we'll come out in the second half with a lot more passion than we did when we played them in the state quarterfinal game. Last year, we had a lot of great seniors who are very good players, but I feel second half they didn't have the drive that we will have this game. They still have the same athletic team that they did last year, But I feel like with our game plan, we can attack and exploit their weaknesses.
I'm sure you've had time to review film. What can we expect from them tonight?
As I said before, really athletic, really fast, good coach players, but they just had a new change of coaching staff and we only have a week of film on them. But we'll be their first game, but I expect that we'll go out there and dominate just like we did.
Noah, thanks for joining us and good luck tonight. We're going to take another quick commercial break, but don't go anywhere because next we'll be changing gears and hearing from our volleyball team, starting with Coach Lloyd. Don't change the channel. We'll be right back.
Come see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McClarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at 6 giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McClarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McClarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McClartyDaniel.com.
When accidents happen, our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge can mean less waiting and faster care. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System Bentonville and Springdale.
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution, connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post. From downtown to way out of town, to connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected and energized with Ozarks Go.
Hey, Northwest Arkansas, Lara here at Sam's Furniture. If you're looking for new furniture, we have over 170,000 square feet selection at everyday low prices and same day delivery available. But the best part is that we love to serve our community. So when you buy at Sam's, part of your purchase goes to support one of the many amazing organizations that we have been blessed to partner with. Serving others, especially those in need, is our culture here, and we hope that you'll be a part of that too. Arkansas's largest furniture destination. Get it at Sam's.
Nothing says game day like good friends and great food. And at Slim Chickens, we know great food. From our 100% all-natural chicken tenders, fresh-made wings served with house sauces, to delicious chicken sandwiches, crisp salads, southern sides, and desserts you just can't get anywhere else. At Slim's, we have the food you love, made fresh for the people you care about. Dine in, drive through, or order online. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
Hey, Riley, will you come in here real quick?
Yeah, man, one sec.
Hey, so I'm just I'm looking through some film myself, and you know, I was thinking if you would take a look at this. In other news, our Wildcat baseball team is going to face off against the...
Hold up. What are you doing with your arm? I mean, you're distracting the audience by your chicken dance.
Well, I just thought it would, you know, bring more attention to myself.
No.
Okay. Now we're going to talk about softball. The softball team, you know, they did okay this year, and it's...
This is totally unprofessional. You're just spinning in circles, and it's not looking good, man.
Well, I thought that maybe the different angles would be kind of cool.
Welcome
back, guys. Here we are back in the Wildcat Sports Network studio. We're going to be talking a little bit about the softball.
Oh, my goodness. I'm done.
Welcome back, sports fans. And joining us now is second-year head coach, Coach Lloyd. Coach, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Coach, real quick, can you talk about the changes you've implemented because of COVID-19 this season?
Sure. So when we first started back in July, we had a lot of restrictions placed on us. So we only had two girls couldn't touch a ball at once. We were sanitizing between everything. So there was no net play, no scrimmaging, a lot of just ball control. Which actually turned out to be a good thing for us. We had to get back to the basics. That's been really nice to start with the basics early. And then once we got full release in the middle of July, it's been pretty good since then. Obviously the masks are a big thing. It's interesting because on the bench, they have to have the masks, the bench and the chairs are spaced out. So that's something that we've been trying to deal with and how to still have bench momentum and energy, and the communication has been a problem. So we're still working through some things, but the girls have adapted well.
Everyone is operating at a 75% capacity rate. How do you keep your team motivated knowing that you're walking into a stadium with almost a non-existent crowd?
Right. So with volleyball, honestly, it hasn't affected us too much with the way it, our home match, we had our first home match last night, and the way the gym was taped off, the families still get to sit together. So not having just one person spaced out has been, made it feel a little bit normal. But our fan base, we weren't restricted too much. So it's been kind of nice for us.
Talk to us a little about your team this year. I know we have returning players like Kaylin Coons and Kat Cooper, but talk to us about this year's team and what you've seen preseason.
Sure. So we have a lot of the big dogs back, like you talked about. Faith Donnell, we had three starters returning, Faith, Kaylin, and Kat, and then Maddox McCracken as well. So we're really, really young this year, but I've been so surprised by them. These kids are some of the hardest workers I've known. The chemistry on the court and off the court has been awesome. So you'll see a lot of new faces on the court this season, but they have stepped up to the challenge. We've pushed them really, really hard in the preseason, and our returners have really pushed and tried to keep our team held to a high standard. And the underclassmen, especially the junior class, has just shined throughout this whole preseason.
Conference play began last night at Bentonville. What can we expect from your Wildcats and the 6A West as a whole?
I think we'll be really competitive as far as conference goes. I think this year's conference season is going to be brutal every single night. So we've got the state champions that are returning, Bentonville. Southside returns, they were the state runners-up. They returned basically their whole entire team. And Fayetteville is really heavy this year as well. They have a sophomore class that has played together forever. And so, and then Rogers is very highly competitive as well. So every single night is going to be a toss-up and just who plays and performs the best that night. So I think our conference play is going to be really interesting and really, really competitive. So we're really looking forward to getting further into our conference season.
Coach, as always, thanks for joining us and good luck Tuesday against Rogers Heritage.
Thank you.
In the meantime, it's time for another quick commercial break, but stay tuned. Up next, Faith Donnell is joining us to give us a first-hand look at what this season has to offer. WCSN will be right back.
Claymax at NWA, it's just an easy, customer-centered experience. Right now is probably the easiest time that I've ever seen to achieve financing for people on maybe even a more expensive vehicle or more accommodating vehicle for their family. I've got the best inventory, I would say, in the state, and my people are not only experienced in the car business, but they're experienced in the people business. Whether you just check us out online or you check us out in person, we want you to visit us. ClayMaxiNWA and ClayMaxiNWA.com.
Hometown. That word still means something here. It means we're neighbors. We do the right thing. We care about your family. And you deserve the very best every time you walk in the front door. Harps. Hometown Fresh.
I need new tires. What size of tire do I need? Will they have my size? Do I need an appointment? When can I get in? How long will that take? Can I drop my car off? Do I have to wait there? What will I do with my kids? Will they have a tire that fits my budget?
Does buying tires have your head spinning? At Tire Tracks, we have all the answers built on over 20 years of local service. With three convenient locations in Northwest Arkansas and over 25 highly skilled technicians, we can answer all your questions and keep your head from spinning.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means faster care. And because we're full service hospitals, a lot more care if you need it. Less waiting, faster care. At Northwest Health System, Bentonville and Springdale.
For over 20 years, Community Clinic has served Washington County with quality and affordable health care. With three wellness centers in Springdale, located at Jones, George, and Elmdale Elementary, our services include primary care, pediatrics, prenatal, behavioral health, and physical therapy. We offer services in English, Spanish, and Marseillaise so that we can help your family. The Community Clinic, healthy people, healthy community.
On the counter, find a hole, Garrett inside the five, touch!
Down, Springdale. Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats!
Yeah.
So Shane Matthews, his lightning fast speed.
No. He's got explosive speed.
Dude, he's lightning fast.
Shane, would you describe your speed as explosive or lightning fast?
What?
Dude, I'm telling you, he's
fast,
explosive.
Dude. Lightning fast.
What's that? Lightning fast.
Lightning fast. Yeah.
Welcome back. Joining us in the studio now is Wildcat Volleyball Senior, Faith Donnell. COVID-19 has changed athletics everywhere. How has this affected your experience this year and your experiences as a senior?
Lots of things are different. So when we have games, we all have to sit 6 feet apart on the bench, which is, it makes cheering and things a little bit more difficult, but we're honestly all trying to make the best out of it. You also have to wear masks like when you're not on the court, so that's a little weird. So once you get back from playing, you have to put your mask back on. But for the most part, we're trying to make everything as ordinary as possible and trying to make it the best and fun season we can. So,
what should we expect from our Lady Wildcats this year?
Hopefully a lot of wins. I feel like the chemistry this year is great. We all get along. We all love each other. It's a hard time right now, so we're all trying to just kind of make the best out of it. And I think you should just like expect really fun games, and hopefully we can have people come out to them, even though it's hard with everything going on. But
this year's team has a lot of younger players. Is this a positive for you guys?
I think it is a positive. Like, all the younger players on our team are so fun and like high energy, and they bring a lot to the team. Like, they're all super talented. So I think it's a really good positive to have them on the team with us. Like Kaylin and Kat and all these, like the juniors and sophomores, they all just bring so much to the team. So,
Faith, thanks for being here. Now, in an effort to give our Wildcats as much screen time as possible, our WCSN crew caught up with senior Libby Hall to take a look at the expectations this season and how COVID-19 has impacted the team. Take a look.
The 2020 volleyball season is underway as the Wildcats took on Fort Smith Northside this past Tuesday. And one of the returning players that is leading by example is Libby Hall.
Libby is, to me, one of the most athletic kids in our team. Her natural athletic ability just comes through naturally, and it's really cool to see that and how she takes that onto the court. One of my favorite things about her is that she leads by example with her voice, but then also her actions. So whatever she says, she backs it up with her actions. And so her teammates respect her because of that, and that kind of results in why she got voted team captain.
I am a team captain, so I'm mostly in charge of like what we wear and kind of keeping our composure on the court.
Being a 3-year varsity member on the Wildcat team, Libby looks to this season as an opportunity to excel. But with COVID-19 precautions, this season looks a little different.
It's really weird because you honestly never know when things are going to be over. So it's really pushed me to make every moment count and not take advantage of anything that we consider to be normal.
Libby's positivity was embraced within the team, and for players like Avery Lanning, they recognized Libby's motivation, which helped carry the team.
Playing with Libby, I've kind of learned like just determination, because she's super determined. She does both cheer and she does volleyball. I feel like she really cares about the team itself and not just like at practice. Like, she makes an effort to go hang out with people like ages lower than her, and she encourages people ages lower than her, and so I think that's really cool, and not just like seniors and people her age.
This season leaves a lot of uncertainty, and games are decided on the week-to-week basis, but for Libby, she has one thought which has been her focus point since day one.
Just enjoy where you're at, like always strive to be better and be better for your teammates, put them before yourselves.
Libby and the Wildcats take on Rogers Heritage this coming Tuesday. Be sure to tune into Wildcat Sports Network for all live stream coverage. For WCSN, I'm Sierra Scarlett.
Our Wildcats take on Rogers Heritage for their second home game of the 2020 season. Be sure to come out and support, but if you feel more comfortable watching from your own couch, as always, WCSN will be there for all live event coverage. Let's take another quick commercial break, but coming up next, Braylon Williams is in the studio. Don't go anywhere. The Wildcat Sports Network will be right back.
At Northwest Health, we've made it easier to schedule a doctor's appointment. Online scheduling for our primary care physicians lets you make an appointment at any time from anywhere. It's the new way to book your next visit. MyNorthwestAnyCare.com.
Come see
see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McClarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McClarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McClarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McClartyDaniel.com.
Choose the Wellness Centers at Springdale Schools. The Wellness Centers in Springdale are perfect for students and teachers. Teachers can go during their planning period, and parents don't have to miss work for students to receive medical care. Offering sports physicals, kindergarten physicals, vaccinations, well child checks, acute care, and more. Wellness centers are located at a school near you. Wellness centers in Springdale Schools, we are your medical home.
Welcome home to Lindsay Living. Affordable rates, available on-site management, attitudes of service, and amenities unmatched make residents love where they live and play. From value-packed basic apartments to resort-style living on golf courses, we manage options to fit your needs and wants. Apply online at lindsaymanagement.com for locations throughout Arkansas and in surrounding states.
Here at HAR-BER, athletes make things run much smoother.
Need a runner. Two seconds slower than the last time, Chris. Come on.
Welcome back. Here with us in the studio is Braylon Williams. Last week, Jinx had a real advantage on that turf. They were really fast. How are you going to contain North Little Rock so that there's not too many big plays?
Well, this week, Coach has backed us up in our single man coverage, so we'll be able to get back a lot faster on the single receiver, and we'll be able to just play further back so that we'll be able to see his routes and where he's going, and if he's going deep, we'll be able to cover that a lot easier.
Tonight you play North Little Rock, who defeated you last year at state playoffs. What have you and your teammates done to prepare for this game, and what would it mean to take home a win?
Well, it always feels good to take home a win. And this week we've just been watching film like every other week, and we've switched people around, switched a couple of positions up so that we'll be able to cover the running back and we'll be able to cover the pass a little bit more.
Because of COVID-19, stadiums have to limit their capacity. Was this strange for you playing, or did it have any effect on you at all?
No, it didn't really have any effect on me, because whenever I'm out on the field, I'm worried about the game. You know, I'm not really focusing on the crowd at all.
What positives can you take away from last week's game?
I think that we definitely gave it our all, and you know, it was definitely discouraging at some points, but defense and offense both, we played to the end. We played through the final whistle.
So by now you've had time to watch film of North Little Rock. What can we expect from them?
We can expect definitely the strong run game. They like to play their offense kind of like ours, and they'll line up in trips or empty and doubles. So I don't think we'll see anything too special out of them, and we'll be able to handle them.
Braylon, thanks for being here today, and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
We're going to take one last commercial break, but when we come back, Coach Wood will be back to break down North Little Rock. WCSN will be right back.
Presented by McClarty Daniel.
If you want fast, easy, and affordable service, visit McClarty Daniel.
Keep your vehicle running like new in our state-of-the-art service facilities. We know your time is valuable. Our factory-certified technicians with decades of experience will get you in and out and back on the road quickly. We service all makes and models at our six convenient locations in Bentonville and Springdale, open 6 days a week.
Visit McClartyDaniel.com to schedule your service appointment today.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution. Connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post. From downtown to way out of town, to connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected and energized with Ozarks Go.
Hey, Northwest Arkansas, Lara here at Sam's Furniture. If you're looking for new furniture, we have over 170,000 square feet selection at everyday low prices and same day delivery available. But the best part is that we love to serve our community. So when you buy at Sam's, part of your purchase goes to support one of the many amazing organizations that we have been blessed to partner with. Serving others, especially those in need, is our culture here, and we hope that you'll be a part of that too. Arkansas's largest furniture destination, get it at Sam's.
Climax at ENWA, it's just an easy, customer-centered experience. Right now is probably the easiest time that I've ever seen to achieve financing for people on maybe even a more expensive vehicle or more accommodating vehicle for their family. I've got the best inventory, I would say, in the state, and my people are not only experienced in the car business, but they're experienced in the people business. Whether you just check us out online or you check us out in person, we want you to visit us. Claymax ENWA and ClaymaxENWA.com.
Hey, Nick, catch.
Back with us now to help close this thing is Coach Wood. Tonight, your team will face North Little Rock. We were defeated by them last year at the state playoffs. Is there anything that your team has been specifically working on from that game last year?
Well, I mean, the biggest change is they've had a coaching change. Coach Mitchell's gone to Alabama to coach. J.R. Eldridge, the former Arkadelphia head coach, is now their head coach. So they're transitioning offensively and defensively. And so the films from last year really doesn't help us prepare. So we've seen their benefit game. So they base out of a different defense offensively. They're basing out something a little bit. So we focused on that more than anything. And really this week goes back to us fixing our own problems and our own challenges and try to be a cleaner football program.
What can we expect from North Little Rock tonight?
Well, they're physical. They've got really good size, athleticism. Defensively, they come out of a forefront. They're a 4-3 team. Got really good size on the D-line, and they get after it. Offensively, they're going to pound the run at you. They're going to try to get the quarterback on the edge, a little bit of quarterback read, stuff like that. So, I mean, I think right now they're ranked number two in the state in one poll, four in the other. So another great test for us. Played number one team in Oklahoma. Now we turn around and play one of the top four teams in the state of Arkansas.
Tonight is a special and unusual one with it being senior night. What are some things you would like to say to your senior class?
Well, the biggest thing I'd like to say to my senior class is I appreciate their perseverance. It's been a very unique since this kicked off for us right around spring break of this year. To be patient, to get going again in June and July. Now we're playing in fall ball. I've enjoyed watching them their whole careers. I remember them in Kwanzaa Day football all the way through Southwest and Central. They're really good young men, and they got big hearts. They love to play the game together and support each other. And I'm just thankful that we've got this game tonight to play, that our governor has given us the chance to play football and watch these young men finish out their senior year on the right note. And special group, going to miss them.
And as always, Coach, to close this out, what can we expect our Wildcats to do to get a win tonight?
Well, I think we're going to be pretty excited to play. We'll play cleaner. We're not going to turn the ball over six times. I think we're going to minimize big plays. I think special teams are really critical in a game like this. I think one of the things that kind of helps us is this is going to be the first game for North Little Rock. They were playing a benefit game last week while we were in Jinx, and some of your best growth in early season is from week one to week two. So I'm really expecting our guys to grow well this week, and I think we're going to play really well tonight.
Thanks for joining us, Coach. That's going to do it for us. Tune in next to watch to honor as our senior class. For Superintendent Dr. Jared Cleveland and Athletic Director Wayne Stellick, I'm Addison Whitney. We'll see you next week.
Right up the middle. He's going to touch on the left-hand side. He's got a first down. That's a touchdown. Harbor Wildcats. Looks to the corner. He's got a man open. Touchdown.